and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Welcome to this morning's service on Mothering Sunday in 2024. I want to thank everybody who's welcomed me. I am covering for Mother Patricia this morning, and I'm very, very glad to be here. In readiness for our service, for meeting our Lord at his table, let us call to mind those things of which we are ashamed, things we have done, things we have omitted to do. Compassion and forgiveness belong to the Lord our God. Though we have rebelled against him, let us then renounce our willfulness and ask his mercy by confessing our sins in penitence and in faith. We confess to you our selfishness and lack of love. Fill us with your Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We confess to you our fear and failure in sharing our faith. Fill us with your Spirit. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
We confess to you our stubbornness and lack of trust. Fill us with your Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon us. Pardon and deliver us from all our sins. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in life eternal through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray. God of compassion, whose Son, Jesus Christ, the child of Mary, shared the life of a home in Nazareth and on the cross drew the whole human family to himself, strengthen us in our daily living, that in joy and in sorrow we may know the power of your presence to bind together and to heal. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated for our readings.
First reading is taken from 1 Samuel 1, 20 to the end. A reading from the book, from the first book of Samuel. Hannah conceived and bore a son. She named him Samuel, for she said, I have asked him of the Lord. The man Elkanah and all his household went up to offer to the Lord the yearly sacrifice and to pay his vow. But Hannah did not go up, for she said to her husband, as soon as the child is weaned, I will bring him, that he may appear in the presence of the Lord and remain there forever. I will offer him as a Nazarite for all time. Her husband Elkanah said to her, do what seems best to you. Wait until you have weaned him only. May the Lord establish his word. So the woman remained and nursed her son until she weaned him. When she had weaned him, she took him up with her, along with a three-year-old bull, an ephah of flour, and a skin of wine. She brought him to the house of the Lord at Shiloh, and the child was young. Then they slaughtered the bull, and they brought the child to Eli. And she said, O my Lord, as you live, my Lord, I am the woman who was standing here in your presence praying to the Lord. For this child I prayed, and the Lord has granted me the petition that I made to him. Therefore I have lent him to the Lord as long as he lives. He is given to the Lord. She left him there for the Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks
The psalm is 127, verses 1 to 4. And the response is, the Lord shall keep watch over your going out and your coming in.
The Lord shall keep watch over your going out and your coming in.
Unless the Lord builds the house, those who build it labor in vain. Unless the Lord keeps the city, the guard keeps watch in vain.
The Lord keep watch over your going out and your coming in.
It is in vain that you hasten to rise up early and go so late to rest, eating bread of toil, for he gives his beloved sleep. Children are a heritage from the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his gift. The Lord shall keep watch over your going out and your coming in.
Reading from Colossians 3, a reading from the letter of Paul to the Colossians. As God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourself with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other, just as the Lord has forgiven you. So you also must forgive. Above all, clothe yourself with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in the one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and with gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do, in the word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you.
not your hearts. Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Standing near the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother, "Woman, here is your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Here is your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his own home. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Can you hear me clearly?
Yes.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Morning Sunday to you all, including those who are joining us online. As we celebrate this modern Sunday, I would like to give a brief overview of the origin of modern Sunday. It is a day honoring mother churches, that is, the church where one is baptized. It has been celebrated since the Middle Ages, that is, 16th century in the United Kingdom, Ireland, some parts of Europe, and some Commonwealth countries. It's usually celebrated on the fourth Sunday in Lent, which is exactly 3 weeks before Easter Sunday. Traditionally, in the United Kingdom, those who have moved away for work would come back and visit their mothers, mother church, and their own mothers. It was originally a day to honor and give thanks to the Virgin Mary, the mother of our Lord Jesus Christ. Such celebrations required people to visit their mother church, that is, the main church or cathedral in a family's area. You may have noticed that members of the Mothers Union, a worldwide Christian organization, joined in the procession at the beginning of this service to celebrate this special day, appreciating the role our mothers played in our lives. At some point at the service, some children will be given flowers to present to the women in the church as a demonstration of our love and appreciation for their care, love, nurture, protection, and sacrifices which our mothers have made on our behalf. We remember the story of Hannah, if you listen carefully during the first reading this morning. Hannah asked for a son. She vowed to dedicate the child to the service of God if God answered her prayers. God had compassion on her and blessed her with a son, whom she called Samuel, because she asked God for him. After Samuel was born, his father, Elkanah, and the rest of the family went to Shiloh, where he prayed and made sacrifices annually. But this time, Hannah did not go with them. This was what she said: "After the boy is weaned, I will take him and present him before the Lord, and he will live there always." That is 1 Samuel chapter 1, verse 22. Hannah has become an example, or has shown an example of a loving and caring mother. We know that every human being and mamas need their mother's milk or similar products in order to survive those crucial days and months. Otherwise, they may die. Have you ever wanted something desperately and prayed and made a promise to God? Each of us may face times of barrenness and frustration when nothing comes to fruition in our workplace, in our homes, or in our relationship. It is difficult to pray in faith when we feel so ineffective. But as Hannah discovered, prayer opens the way for God to work. That is 1 Samuel 1, 19 to 20. Be careful, however, what you promise in prayer, because God may take it up on you. Hannah so desperately wanted a child that she was willing to make a vow to God. God took her up upon her promise and granted her a son. To Hannah's credit, she did her part, even though it was painful. Read 1 Samuel chapter 1, verses 27 to 28. Although we are not in a position to do a trade by matter with God or to strike a bargain with him, he may still choose to answer a prayer with an attached promise. When you are in such a situation and you pray, ask yourself and be honest to yourself: will I fulfill this promise if God grants my request? It is dishonest and dangerous to disregard a promise, especially to God. We have a faithful Father who answers us when we pray to him. He keeps his promises and expects us to fulfill our promises, to fulfill any promises we have made. In our reading from John's Gospel, our Lord Jesus Christ demonstrated his love for his mother Mary. Even as he was going through the agony of death, he still had concern for the care and welfare of his mother after he had gone. It must have been a painful sight too for Mary, watching helplessly her dear son going through the agony and humiliation of the cross. Can you imagine what the environment would have looked like with Jesus hanging on the cross, those four women with John, filled with sadness and hopelessness, standing and watching. As mothers, can we imagine how Mary could have felt at that time? In the middle of all this, Jesus looked at his mother, Mary, and said, "Dear woman, here is your son." And to John, he said, "Here is your mother." The Bible tells us that from that time, John took her into his home. That is John 19, verse 27. Just imagine the level of anguish that is mixed with intense love here. Even while Jesus was dying on the cross, he was concerned about his mother and her welfare after he had gone. As John, whom the Bible describes as the one Jesus loved, stood with the four women at the foot of the cross, Jesus said to him, "Here is your mother." In other words, take care of her as you care for your own mother. We can see that John was a truly trusted friend of Jesus. All the other disciples have gone into hiding, including Peter the rock. But John and Mary stood by Jesus, regardless of the danger or accusation they might face. What does this tell us about Mary and John? For John, it means a true friend will be ready to stand by you through thick and thin, even at the risk of losing their own life. A mother's true love knows no bound. That's for Mary. A true mother is ready to risk her life in order to save her child or children. She ensures that her children get the best before thinking of herself. I have watched on television in situations of war or famine where everybody was starving due to lack of food. Emaciated and malnourished mothers were seen making all efforts to breastfeed their babies. Scenes like this portrays the love a dedicated mother has for her child. The responsibility of being a mother is enormous and must never be taken lightly. God makes mothers the custodians or caretakers of his children. Therefore, mothers must remember that we will give accounts to God of how we have cared for the children we have put in our care. The Bible says, "Train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not turn from it." That's Proverbs 22:6. God expects us to care for the child or the children physically by feeding and protecting him or her from danger. Mentally, by providing safe, secure, and loving environment. And spiritually, by telling them the word of God, by teaching them the word of God and sharing the love of God within our homes, with our friends, and in our communities, so that as they grow up, that love will have an impact in their lives. The Holy Spirit will not allow them to be led astray by any negative outside influence. Children also have a role to play. The fifth commandment says, honor your father and your mother so that you may live long in the land that the Lord your God is giving you. That's Exodus 20, verse 12. This is the first commandment with a promise. By honoring the parents, the children are expected to speak with their parents politely and show them courtesy and respect. It means following their teachings and examples of putting God first. Even those who find it difficult to get on with their parents are still commanded to honor them. One of the main objectives of the Mothers' Union is to protect and promote stable Christian homes where children are brought up with the fear and nurture of the Word of God, and to support those whose family life has met with adversity. May God guide all parents as we teach our children to know the truth, in Jesus' name. Amen.
We will say the prayers together. We believe in one God.
We pray for mothers and godmothers everywhere and for the gift of mothering, which is shared amongst us all. On this day, let us celebrate with you, Lord, the joy and the pain experienced by mothers. We are all sons or daughters, and all our lives and upbringing
to those who brought us into the world as part of your creation. May the love that your Son showed his mother Mary shine in our lives too. And may our duty of care to our mothers be transfused with love, affection, and gratitude. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for Mother Anna, a priest in charge at St. Aldhelm's, for Mother Patricia, curate here at St. Aldhelm's, for Mother Miriam, who is presiding and leading us today. May the Mother Church, in which we have grown in faith, be blessed with the care and affection we show to our parents. May authority be mixed with nurture, and teaching mixed with learning, so that we can become mature Christians in your presence, Lord. Help us shape the environment in which we worship, so that our lives can show the benefits of a growing spirituality, walking closely with our God. Lord, in your mercy, we know that nothing is plain sailing in this world, Lord. But we also know that whatever we do, if it is done in the name of the Lord Jesus, and if we give you thanks through him, all will be well in the end. Send us out to listen to your people and spread your word in the knowledge that you will be alongside us in every difficulty as well as every delight. Help us to make a difference in your world in prayer and action and word and deed. At this time, we pray especially for people worldwide who are in turmoil and torn apart by war and national disaster. Protect, comfort, and heal all those involved, especially women and children who face unspeakable loss. Lord, in your mercy, show compassion, Lord, on all who are sick. Bring relief to those who feel pain and hope to those who face treatment, as we especially pray for mothers facing sickness, for Mother Anna, who is not well, for those who have asked for our prayers, those within our church family, at home and abroad. Lord, in your mercy, we ask that those who have died are now at peace with you, as we remember High Some Small, our dear sister, who was laid to rest this week. And we also remember our brother Uzo Nene, and all those whose memory is specially dear to us on Mothering Sunday. Bring comfort to family and friends, and may they know your love. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us access to his grace. May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Thank you.
indeed right and good to give you thanks and praise, Almighty God and everlasting Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son. For in these 40 days you lead us into the desert of repentance, that through a pilgrimage of prayer and discipline we may grow in grace and learn to be your people once again. Through fasting, prayer, and acts of service, you bring us back to your generous heart. Through study of your holy word, you open our eyes to your presence in the world and free our hands to welcome others into the radiant splendor of your love. As we prepare to celebrate the Easter feast with joyful hearts and minds, we bless you for your mercy and join with saints and angels forever praising you and saying, so that we, in the company of St. Aldhelm and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, and with whom, and in whom,
In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray with confidence, as our Savior has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Lord, we thank you for this beautiful gift of your body and blood. And we say to them, Almighty God,
we thank you for feeding us with the body and the blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, who gave me your offering of our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out to the power of your Spirit to live and work to your grace and glory.
Notices in a few minutes, but the choir are going to sing for us a song especially for Mother's Day. I want to thank particularly Mother's Union for leading us, as mothers do, in prayer and in a right attitude to God and in our singing. Thank you for our preaching today.
And during the singing, the flowers will be given out.
Thank you.
together every Sunday at 6. Do please come along to support your church. There's a training day on the 17th of March for all the volunteers of this church. And on Mother's Day, we should remember that the volunteers of this church, Mother and look after all of us. And please talk to Julie Willoughby. Do you know Julie Willoughby here? No?
She is.
She is. Where is she? Talk to Julie Willoughby about donations and names of your loved ones who have died, so that the Easter Lily can be honored there. The last day to do that is next Sunday. Sunday 2 weeks, sorry, Palm Sunday. All the dates for the week are in your service sheet. And once again, many, many thanks to the Mothers Union for their strong support for this service this morning. I just want to tell you, as a stranger in the land, that you've got a lovely church here. We have a warm, welcoming, lovely church. And thank you for my welcome this morning. Thank you, Mother in me. Okay.
I would like to say a very big thank you, Pastor, to Mother Miriam, who came today to step in for us because our two priests are not available today. We thank you very, very much, and we enjoyed the service, and we hope you did. Thank you so much. And next time, come and help us.
Close as we normally do. May Christ give you grace to grow in holiness, to deny yourselves, to take up your cross and follow him. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
The whole birthday is gone. So sorry, has anyone had a birthday this week?
Yes.
Yes? Good. Okay. Got to arm. Right. Come up, be someone too. God bless you for this coming year and on this very special week of your birthday, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. And we sing.
Any travellers? Anybody travelling?
Anybody travelling?
I can pray for
no.
you.
No. Apart from two from work, two from shops, no. Now sing. Shining with light.